Hello, Valerie from BabyWiseMom.com talking with you today all about your baby's ninth month. This will be weeks 35 to 39. When your baby starts this month, your baby will be 8 months old, and by the end of this month, your baby will be 9 months old. Before we get started, don't forget to like this video and to subscribe to my channel. This is another very great month as far as schedules go because, again, very little actually changes. Let's talk about eat first. Just as your baby did last month, your baby should have 4 feedings a day. If your baby didn't last month, look for 4 feedings to happen this month. That means if you had a dream feed, you'll be dropping that. That also means feedings will be 4 hours apart for 4 feedings in a 24-hour period. By this age, you want to be aiming for 3 solid feedings every day. You also can start finger foods if you haven't already. Some signs that your baby's ready to start finger foods is that your baby can chew, make the chewing motion, that your baby's interested in finger foods, and also that your baby can pick up the food and bring it to his mouth. Some really good first foods for finger foods include Cheerios, natural cheeses, crackers, ripe fruit, vegetables. Cooked vegetables are good, but you can also do not cooked vegetables. Next, we'll talk about sleep. For sleep, at this age, your baby most likely will be ready for 2 naps a day. If your baby still has 3 naps a day, be watching for signs that your baby's ready to drop that 3rd nap. That can include baby not sleeping well for that 3rd nap, having a hard time going to sleep at bedtime, waking up early the next morning, or not napping well during the day for the other 2 naps. So most babies this age will have 2 naps a day. But if your baby isn't ready to drop that 3rd nap, don't press it, don't force it. Not every baby will be ready for just 2 naps a day at this age. Those first 2 naps each day should be 1.5 to 2 hours long for each nap. Sometimes some babies will take a 2.5 hour long nap, and that's fine. If that's what your baby needs, go with it. If your baby still has a 3rd nap, that 3rd nap is most likely a short nap that is anywhere from 30 to 60 minutes long. At night, your baby will be sleeping 10 to 12 hours each night. Speaking of getting frustrated, if your baby is having tantrums or not obeying you, it's okay to have boundaries. Don't feel bad about having boundaries. It's okay to tell your baby no, and it's okay to have rules. So this is a great age to start, because if you start teaching your baby to listen now, then as your baby becomes a toddler, those tantrums become easier to manage, and I promise toddler tantrums are much bigger than baby tantrums. Another fun thing about playtime is independent playtime. Now that your baby is older and more mobile, you can start to extend how long independent playtime is each day. Look to have independent playtime be 30 to 45 minutes long. Now for the fun milestones to watch for. Your baby might start to reach for things that are a little bit out of reach, may start to work to try to get those. Your baby will be looking for objects that are dropped, objects that are out of sight that were in sight, and that's part of why separation anxiety has started in the past and might be still present at right now, as your baby realizes, like, mom was here and now mom's not, and that's upsetting. Your baby might also be able to pull to standing, or start to crawl or creep, to sit up after having been on the floor, get to sitting by herself. And as I mentioned, your baby might be able to say words. Now, always remember that these milestones happen at different rates for every baby, and also can only be reached if your baby has opportunity to practice them. If your baby does not spend time on the floor, then learning to crawl isn't as likely to happen as a baby who spends time each day in a position able to practice that. But once again, if you have concerns with any milestones, it is always wise to talk to your baby's doctor about that. Your baby might run into some sleep issues this month. We're still in the range. The last couple of months I've talked about common sleep issues. We are still in the range for those sleep issues to be present. So let's review. Your baby might not be sleeping well because of hunger. So a growth spurt might be happening. Your baby needs to eat more often. Your baby might not be sleeping well because of teething or sickness or some other pain. Again, your baby might not sleep as well if that third nap needs to be dropped, so definitely look at that if you still have a third nap. Babies will not sleep as well as they become more curious and want to explore the world around them, so they might be thinking back to how fun it was to be playing and be really anxious to get back to that instead of in bed. Changes to the schedule and daily life can interrupt sleep, so moving, sickness is a change that can have happened, holidays, traveling, any of those little things can interrupt sleep. Your baby might not sleep as well if wake time length needs to change, be extended a little bit. When you extend wake time length, don't go too far. Take it in little increments. Add 5 minutes, 10 minutes, but don't think, oh, my baby probably needs a longer wake time length, and add 30 minutes. Then you've probably gone beyond and your baby's now overly tired because your baby was awake too long instead of not long enough. So take it slowly, take notes, and try to find that perfect amount in slow increments. You might also find your baby needs more stimulation, and that is something that will be very true over the next few months also, so keep that in mind. You've always had to be really careful up to this point about not overstimulating your baby. Overstimulation can still happen, and it can happen even for toddlers. But what's more likely to happen now in a day-to-day, regular, daily life basis is that your baby will be understimulated because you're so careful about keeping your baby to not be overstimulated. So you want to make sure your baby has enough time to physically try to move as best your baby can. So get those gross motor skills in, and also some mental stimulation. Something like going for a walk every day can be great mental stimulation for your baby. So find things that introduce the world to your baby and keep your baby learning and the mind active. And of course, those new skills, if your baby starts to learn to crawl or to sit up or to stand up, pull to standing, that's going to interrupt sleep. So if your baby has learned, I can pull myself up in my crib and stand there, usually the baby can't quite get back down. So that will interrupt sleep. Just as new skills have potentially been disrupting sleep for a few months, that will continue. And last but not least is that diaper change. So if your baby is waking up with a really full diaper, try moving to a larger size diaper. Like if your baby's wearing a size 3 diaper, have your baby sleep at night in a size 4 diaper so that it gives a little bit extra room for your baby. Okay, that finishes up your baby's 9th month overview. If you would like to see sample schedules for this age group, as always, if you're on the blog, scroll down to see those. If you're not on the blog, head on over and check out sample schedules for this age group, as well as all other baby age groups and toddler age groups. And I do have some preschooler and child and even teen schedules.